Bobwhite and scaled quail populations have declined over much of their range in Texas during the last 30 years. Habitat management techniques, such as prescribed burning and brush sculpting, are often used to try to increase quail abundance. But do such practices work? Do quail populations increase in response to our management efforts? Landowners and managers need a way of estimating quail populations on their properties and monitoring population fluctuations over time. Such estimates would allow managers to gauge the effectiveness of their management efforts. Quail populations in Texas are often eruptive, that is, they have distinct boom and bust trends. Figure 2A shows the statewide roadside bobwhite quail trends, while Figure 2B shows the statewide roadside scaled quail trends. The goal of quail management should be to maximize quail abundance in good years and minimize decline in bad years. Tracking the magnitude of fluctuations can aid in management decisions. Managers have several options for assessing quail population trends. None of the techniques are completely accurate, but when done consistently for several years, the results can indicate the trend of a local quail population and how it responds to management. The survey methods vary in their degree of difficulty. The techniques, with a few exceptions, are applicable to bobwhite and scaled quail throughout Texas. Several direct counts include roadside counts, helicopter surveys, covey flush rates, drive counts, line transect counts, and mark recapture. Roadside counts. This method is used by the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department to index quail populations at an ecoregion level, but can also be used by land managers. Roadside counts are usually conducted in August or September. Helicopter surveys. Aerial surveys conducted from a helicopter or airplane have been recently used to survey quail. Generally, a quail survey is conducted in conjunction with a deer survey. Helicopter surveys are a form of line transect survey. Although counting quail from helicopters is experimental, preliminary findings suggest that the results are similar to those from line transect counts. Covey flush rates. Hunting success is positively correlated to the population densities of bobwhites. When using hunting success to estimate population trends over the years, hunting methods should be standardized, including factors such as the presence or absence of dogs, the daily start and finish times, and whether or not hunting takes place on baited roads. The entire management unit should be hunted to generate an accurate estimate. The important variable to be recorded is the number of coveys flushed per hour, not the number of birds harvested. This number can then be compared with the size of the area covered to generate an estimate of coveys per unit of area. Drive counts. Drive counts are conducted by several observers walking abreast and counting all quail that flush. Observers must be careful not to count the same birds twice. The more observers there are, the less space will be between them, and the more accurate the count will be. At least 15 to 25% of the property should be sampled. Line transect counts. Line transect counts are a labor-intensive method of estimating quail abundance, but they may yield the most accurate results. An observer walks along a straight line or transect and counts the number of birds flushed. Mark recapture. The most accurate method of estimating population is mark recapture, which involves trapping and marking quail and then recapturing birds at a later date. This method is costly, labor-intensive, and requires special permits from the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department. Indirect counts include call counts, spring call counts, fall covey counts, age ratios, and dummy nests. Call counts. Call counts are simply counts of whistling quail. There are two types of call counts for bobwhites, spring for mating and fall for covey. Scale quail do not have a fall covey call, so only spring call counts apply to them. Spring call counts. Spring call counts are conducted in spring and early summer. Only the bobwhite, poor bobwhite whistle and scale quail walk are recorded for spring call counts. Peak calling is typically observed in May and early June in Texas, so surveys should be conducted during this time period. Fall covey counts. Covey calls of bobwhites are often called wake-up calls. Covey calls are typically heard during the fall and winter, from October to March, in the early morning, about 30 minutes before official sunrise. Calling sessions are generally brief, lasting from 30 seconds to several minutes. Age ratios. The increase in the annual quail population from reproduction is an indicator of management success and the influence of other environmental factors. Keeping stringent harvest records can give you an indication of population change over the years. The ratio of adult to juvenile quail in the hunter's bag is a measure of productivity and survival since the breeding season. More productive breeding seasons, including cooler, wetter summers, yield a higher percentage of juveniles in the bag. Dummy nests. Dummy nests are simulated quail nests containing three chicken eggs used to monitor nest survival. A group of simulated nests are established and then monitored weekly for a given time period, which is normally 28 days. Designing a monitoring system. Surveying quail allows managers to gauge the effectiveness of their management practices. Here are some guidelines. Use more than one survey method. This will help offset biases from particular surveys and allow you to compare results from different surveys. Establish a permanent route using steel T-posts complete with permanent markers. If the property is large enough, perhaps 2,000 acres, post listening posts at 1 mile intervals. Listening posts can also be used as photo points for you to take pictures at the same time each year to demonstrate changes in habitat over time. Keep detailed management records. This includes individual counts, precipitation records, harvest records, livestock grazing records, habitat manipulations, and management changes. Summarize records across years to reveal patterns that aid in making management decisions. Consistency is key. Conduct surveys consistently, but don't be afraid to try new techniques. Maintain at least one baseline survey across the years. Texas Quail Index. The TQI is a long-term demonstration that uses several methods to correlate these indices mentioned with the number of birds encountered during the hunting season. The TQI website contains preliminary results and also has protocols and data sheets for each of the techniques described. For more information on quail population surveys or the Texas Quail Index, contact your county extension agent or local Texas Parks and Wildlife biologist, or visit the websites listed below. The information contained in this video is available for purchase from the Texas A&M AgriLife Bookstore, publication B6173, titled Counting Quail.